सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतं वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै ब्रह्मदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मोक्षो वै शरणं। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धेर्दुर्गत्वं पारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महां सदेवानन्दं निश्चितामतिः। ईदृक् भेद सद्भावादेव लक्ष्यार्थम अवलंब्य ब्रह्म शब्दस्य अर्थो भिन्नतया निरूपितः। सो ब्रह्म शब्द वाच्यार्थ ऑफ ब्रह्म शब्द इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी ईश्वर, वेर एज लक्ष्यार्थ इज शुद्ध चैतन्य और सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म। नाउ द क्वेश्चन विच वॉज रेज, if shruti does not reveal dvaita through mantra such as dvasuparna, then jiva brahma bhedha is not possible, and if it is not possible then karma and upasana both will be vyartha as prescribed by the shruti, and shruti does not prescribe nirarthaka, something which is nishprayojana, something which is vyartha. If we agree in one aspect of the shruti, in karma or upasana or in anything, in one part of the shruti, if you say that no, that is vyartha, an injunction is vidhi is vyartha, then it can be applicable anywhere, or it is called as ardha jarati anyaya. One part of the person is aging while the other part remains young. That is not possible. So we should not use ardha jaratiya nyaya. What is agreeable, I take. What is not agreeable, I just let it go without any explanation. That should not be the case. You should take every vidhi as valid, as having prayojana. So saprayojana vidhi. All vidhis have prayojana. So karma and upasana also have prayojana. If they have prayojana, karma should give karma phala. Karma phala cannot be given by yourself. There has to be someone else who gives you something. That someone else is Ishwara, who is Karma Phala Data. Karma Phala Data has to be different from the Sampradana, Karma Phala recipient. That is the reason one does karma and gets it. Now there is Bheda between the Karma Phala Datru and Karma Phala Sampradana. So Jiva, who does karma and gets karma phala, has to be different from Ishvara. This is revealed by Dvasuparna mantra also. One partakes, one is a bhogi, bhokta, whereas the other is abhokta. He watches over. That is the mantrartha in Dvasuparna. When two birds are sitting on the same tree, one is a bhokta, sadhu phalamatte, whereas the other just swadhu phalamatti, and the other is looking over, swadvatti. So dvasuparna iti shrutya jiva brahma bhedha avagamyata iti anyatha karmopasana vidivayartham iti cha shankaya samadhana. What is the answer to that question, the doubt raised? It has to be dvaita only, it cannot be advaita, meaning Ishvara has to be bhinna from jiva. Otherwise, upasana also. We saw karma. Upasana is not possible. Upasana is done on an upasya. That upasya has to be different from you. Therefore, since Shruti prescribes saprayojana upasana, therefore the upasya has to be different from the upasaka. Not only that, there are other bhedas also. There is phalata upasana, there is a gati involved, there is a loka involved, there is a different kind of prapti involved. All these are in dvaita, they are not possible in advaita. There the samadhana given is chaitanya bhaso bhunte kutastaha asanga prakashate. Chaitanya bhasa, you've seen abhasa is one ansha of jiva, abhasa is one ansha of Ishvara also. Chaitanya is a common ansha, abhasa is different in the vyashti and samashti. That abhasa, chaitanya abhasa bhunte is the bhukta, kutastha asangaha prakashate. So the dvasuparna mantra is not talking about jiva and Ishvara, but talking about the abhasa and chaitanya. The differentiation is the level, is at the level of abhasa, who can be jiva or Ishvara, and chaitanya, who is shuddha. But in the example, when abhasa bhunte also, abhasa is the bhukta. Which abhasa is the bhukta? Abhasas are different. So the abhasa of the jiva, jivagata abhasa, chaitanya abhasa bhunte, jiva who has the chaitanya amsha called as kutastha, he is asanga, which is called as brahma at the samashti level, is asangaha. And the abhasa at the samashti level is not called as a bhokta. So abhasa and chaitanya bheda is to be understood in the bheda. Yes, dvaita is there. What is the dvaita there? Mithya abhasa and satya chaitanya. Those who are deluded count the abhasa also as a separate entity, and thereby say there is real dvaita. There is no real dvaita, because any number of reflections in the mirror cannot be counted when the bimba is single. Bimba is single, whereas pratibimbas are many. Pratibimbas are mithya. You cannot say, you know, generally if you look at some restaurants have mirrors, you know, or some shops also have mirrors to show that the shop is big, there are many people. Because there is some bhranti. When you enter and you see lot of people, you think, oh, something is, you know, something valid is happening there. Something, you are interested in such a thing. So generally human nature, you see, oh, there is a lot of demand. So they put mirrors where many people get reflected, but the presence is of only some people. They are real. The pratibimbas are bhranti. You cannot count them as people. Oh, so many people are there. Only 5 or 10 people may be there. They'll appear as, you know, 30, 40 people. If you put mirrors on both sides, on one side, if you'll see double the number of people. So that is our case. We have ended up counting mithya also, pratibimbas also, along with the bimba. Whereas bimba is kutastha asanga, where and chaitanya abhasa mithya is the bhokta. Chaturvidam chaitanya muktam. So you have seen the four types in the chaitanya itself. Tatra jiva swarupa antaragata mithya bhuta chidabhasa ausha eva punya pape krutva tat phalam anubhavati na kutastha. Who is the karta bhokta? Here bhokta is mentioned. If the in the dvasuparna mantra, one is shown as a bhokta, bhoga cannot be, you know, without reason. There is no free lunch. The jiva has earned it. Therefore, The bhokta has been karta in the past. So is karta bhokta. Bhokta when it is said, karta is included. You cannot have bhoktrutvam without kartrutvam. Therefore, jiva swarupa antaragata mithyabhuta chidabhasa amshaha, that part of called as chidabhasa in the description of jiva swarupa, within that there are the amshas, multiple amshas, basically three amshas. Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya, which is Bimba, Pratibimba, inside a medium. That medium happens to be Avidya, manifest as Buddhi. So Buddhi as well as Avidya, both are Mithya. So medium is Mithya. What about Pratibimba? Pratibimba is Mithya. That mithya bhuta chidabhasa amsha or pratibimba, in other words, eva punya pape kritva, having done punya and papa, tat phalam anubhavati, get sukha or dukha, or sukha sadhana, dukha sadhana, or sukha vishaya, dukha vishaya, based on punya and papa respectively. Natu kutastha, kutastha na bhungte, na tat phalam anubhavati. Satu asangataya ananda swarupayo prakashate. Ananda swarupayo prakashate. Shuddha Chaitanya, which is also Sat Swarupa and Ananda Swarupa, that Ananda Swarupa is sought after by each and every one. The manifestation of that very Swarupa, one's own nature, is what is sought after in each and every phala, which is the reason that one becomes a karta. One does any karma by becoming a karta to become a bhokta of that phala. Which kind of phala? Ananda Swarupa manifest. Without knowing that Ananda Swarupa is your real Swarupa, that to kutastha is asanga. Remaining asanga makes the Ananda manifestation possible. So, what is the case in the example used, with the example used? The mirror or jala which was shown there, the jala reflects the bimba. So, the jala reflecting the bimba will be clear only when the water is not muddy. Water has to be clean, or the patra has to be clean. In the case of the mirror has to be clean, the darpana has to be clean. Unless it is clean, the reflection is not clear. Similarly, in the exemplified, as long as chitta or buddhi is clouded, ananda does not manifest well, does not reflect well, which is on swarupa. So, chidabhasa amsha, although we see chitta abhasa, it is not only chidabhasa. Chit is also an upalakshana. There is a sadabhasa, there is an anandabhasa. That anandabhasa is not clear. Abhasa is there when there is vishaya anubhava. When vishaya anubhava, which is wanting, a person wanted the vishaya ananda, and when one gets it, then there is Priyamoda Pramoda Vritti, based on how much one is closer to the Vishaya. If it is far, then there is Dukkha. Ananda does not manifest at all because the Kama for the Vishaya is clouding the Buddhi. Once the Vishaya comes in proximity, then the Kama goes away in such a manner that, oh, I am going to get it. I am going to get this Vishaya which I have longed for. Thereby, there is a Priya Vritti. That is the Kama reducing and less clouding in the Antakkarana. Thereby, Ananda manifests better. There is an Ananda Abhasa in the form of Priya Vritti. Oh, I like this. So, there is some Sukha. Oh, I like this. You know, somebody talks about a Priya Vastu, a dear friend, or you know, something that you like. To have bhoga, something that you like to eat. So, spouse or mother tells you, oh, I made this. And then, you know, anyone at home, you like it, and then you hear that, you have a smile. Because Ananda manifests Priya. Then when it is served, when the Vishaya is accessible so close that in the next moment, it is up to me when to have Bhoga. Then there is Modavritti. That is better manifestation of Ananda. So Ananda Abhasa is more. Then when you partake it, there is Pramoda Abhasa. Ananda Abhasa becomes Pramoda because you have already become one as though. The Chaitanya underlying the Vishaya and you are one, which is you, not Chaitanya underlying you. What you call as you call yourself, one who is the Bhokta. And that is through the Vritti itself. Therefore, this Ananda Swarupa Eva Prakashate means it just by being of that nature, the Kutastha Chaitanya, which is your one's real nature, that manifests by not associating at all. The Bimba has no association with the Darpana or Jala where there is Pratibimba. Yaduktam Yaduktam Buddhis Rupa Vrikshe Jiyav Paramatma Cheti Dvau Suparano Dvau Pakshinav Staha. So Dvasuparna is here you see the mantra as Dvasuparna in the Mundaka Upanishad. That's a Chandasa Prayoga. Dvasuparna is Dvau Suparano. And Suparna, Parna is wings. There, Suparna, yeah, basically birds. So, Pakshino. Meaning of Suparna is Pakshino. So, Dau Pakshino Staha. There are two birds. Buddhi Rupa Vrikshe. So, in the Buddhi, comparable to Vriksha, there are Jiva and Paramatma comparable to two birds. This is the explanation given to the Dvasuparna mantra. Tayoho jivaha karma phalam bhunte. Explanation given by whom? By Dvaitins. Superficial interpretation. Literal interpretation. When there is a simile, you cannot apply it as it is. So, tayoho jivaha karma phalam bhunte. Jiva partakes of karma phala paramatma tam prakashayan naste. Prakashayan is shatranta but nijanta also. Nijanta hetumati nich. So causative. Prakashayan naste. Paramatma karma phalam prakashayan naste. Tam there. Not tam, tam need not be karma phalam. Karma phala is neuter. So should have been tat. But we can say, generally it is used tam, jeev. So you can say jeeva also. Prakasha naaste. Actually, tat would be better. Samani napunsakam also and reveals everything. So Paramatma reveals everything. And reveal a causing the it to be revealed. And the causative there is what? Just being there. In fact, this reminds me, the Vyakarana Sutra. Those who have studied sutras, the definition of Karta, meaning Kartrukaraka. Karta in Vyakarana Shastra is what? Swatantra Karta. One who is Swatantra is Karta. So this fellow here, Jiva, is Swatantra. But if you look at it, isn't Paramatma Swatantra? You cannot say Ishvara is not Swatantra. So thereby Paramatma is also Karta. If you look at it by Vyakarana Shastra. And if you inquire into it, who is the real Karta? Definition of Vyakarana Shastra. Jiva is not a Karta. Who is doing everything then? If I give up, I stop acting, still things get done. Guna guneshu vartante iti matva na sajjate. So dhira viveki, who knows that I am not the karta, remains separate. How is that possible? Then how are things getting done? They are getting done because it is prarabdha, it is meant to be. They will get done. Whether you participate or not, it will get done. Then who is the karta? There is another sutra. after immediately after that tat prayojaka hetuscha, one who facilitates that any which way can also be called as karta, who is a hetu karta. In vyakarana is called as a hetu karta, that is a causative. Nikarta called as nikarta. So prakashayan aste revealing that, but here prakashakarta you have to say, then prakashayan shatru is a replacement, shatru pratyaya is a replacement for latlakara. Shatrushana chau, for that you use latlakara, for lat, latas shatrushana chau. Shatru and shanacha are replacements for latlakara. So there is latlakara means what? The karta is revealed there. Karma can also be revealed, but karta, if you look at it, prakasha, and then he is a prakasha karta. No, by mere presence. Mere presence, things get done. That is the idea there. Even if you take the Jiva and Paramatma as the interpretation, but then Jiva and Paramatma have difference between the two, that is not true. Iti dva suparneti shruter artha. This is the objection. Iti tatra uchyate. There, what is the answer given? Na tatra jiva paramatmanau grahyau. By two birds, you should not take the simile for jiva and paramatma as being depicted in the simile as birds, but kintu abhasa karma phalam bhunte kutastha prakashamana aste iti tasya shruter arthajneha. What should be understood is that one bird is the bhokta, definitely so. The other bird is shuddha chaitanya. The one who is partaking is not kutastha, the other is kutastha, and one who is partaking is abhasa. So jiva shabda, if you use, even if you jiva shabda is used for abhasa primarily, because it is vachyartha. Lakshyartha should be taken only when vachyartha does not fit. Jiva is a combination of all three. Paramatma is also a combination of all three. There jiva, if even if you have interpreted it, there is no word jiva and paramatma there. If you interpret as jiva and paramatma, because it is, that is what it appears, you know. Generally, Purana katha, oh, you know, jiva is praying, paramatma is giving. Ishvara is giving the blessing, the devotee with whatever he wants. And this is the process in every religion. Jiva, an individual, is always asking for something or the other. Nothing wrong in it, but then, as Pujya Swami would say, a consumer, never a contributor per se. Overall, you know, if you look at, always limited, has limited skills, therefore, always a wanting person, always praying for vastus, vishayas, and then Paramatma gives. In fact, this is one of the attraction of other religions also. Let that be. Now, our Lord gives whatever you want, whereas your Lord does not give. This is an argument placed by some religions. So, Jiva Paramatma Bheda, if you keep making based on such assumptions, with such background, if you interpret the mantra, even then we can land on it, because we have seen Jiva has the three components, Paramatma has the three components. Jiva, by Jiva Shabda, Vachyartha fits. Paramatma Shabda also Vachyartha fits. However, when you look at the Bheda, the Chaitanya parts, if you take, then Chaitanya has no Bheda. They are Upadhikrata Bhedas. Therefore, if you compare the Jiva Gata Chaitanya and Paramatma Gata Chaitanya, Shabda, what the Shabda reveals, Padartha Gata Chaitanya also, then Chaitanya Chaitanya ho, Bheda Nasti. Chidabhasa and Chidabhasa you take, there is Bheda. And Chidabhasa is Pratiphalana. That is which have come up as a result of some kind of a combination. Thereby, one cannot assume that it is Chaitanya or even the Jada medium, the medium of reflection, which is like darpana or the jala which reflects. That part, the medium also, the reflecting medium is not the artha. Even when you take jiva and paramatma, what is the meaning? Which is the resultant. The resultant is the actor. Resultant being the actor, that has to be chidabhasa. So jiva is the, in the jiva you take the chidabhasa, who is the actor. And paramatma, at the level of abhasa you can make a division, but at the level of chaitanya you cannot make a division. So there, if you understand that, because there is a mantra which follows, you cannot just hold on to this mantra. If this mantra you can explain the bheda, you will not be able to explain the next mantras, set of mantras which follow, where they say that after he knows the truth about the second bird, then he no longer is a samsari, no longer a bhokta. How is that possible? If you know Ishvara as Ishvara separate from you, how do you not become a bhokta? You will continue to be a bhokta. Even in the Dvaita Moksha, you will be a bhokta. Because the person is craving to have the darshana of the Lord, have a close proximity to the Lord, have the same loka of the Lord, have the same rupa of the Lord, or become an ausha of the Lord, all the way bhokta. This bhoktrutam will not go in Dvaita Mukti. Dvaita Mukti is no mukti, it is not nitya. Only that mukti or moksha which is nitya can be called as moksha. So if you go further and not do independent mantra analysis without support from other mantras, you will end up contradicting. So Shruti will be contradictory to itself, which is not possible. Therefore, the misunderstanding is in the interpreter, who assumes that Jiva and Paramatma are Grahya by the two birds, those Uparano. Really, Abhasa is to be understood from Jiva Shabda, and from Paramatma, the Parama Atma has been used. Mind you, para, Paratma, Paratma or Paramatma, Para or Param Shabda is the highest. And highest or the most superior or most subtle or most interior is the meaning of Atma also. Atma meaning, the way we saw yesterday, the meaning of Brahma, generally Brahma is used for Nirguna. And Ishvara used for Saguna, but sometimes used for the other, respectively. Similarly, Atma, here Atma, what is the main meaning? Whenever one says Atma, it is definitely the Pratyagatma. Very rarely used for something else. But when you say Atma, then it has to be Pratyagatma. Individual level itself, it is being talked. So when it is being talked about at an individual level, Atma is Pratyagatma, which is Para. So you keep on going more and more interior, where you reach a limit. Sa kashta sa paragatihi. When you cannot go any further, you have nothing to draw. In the Panchakosha Viveka, why Pancha? Because after fifth, there is no sixth that you can draw. You can drop off everything, but you cannot drop off yourself. That is the Pratyagatma. Who is Para? That is the meaning of this Paramatma as Kutastha Chaitanya, who cannot be dropped. The Karta Bhokta Jiva Aumsha can be dropped, but the Chaitanya Aumsha, Kutastha Aumsha of Jiva cannot be dropped. That is the meaning of Paramatma there, and Jiva means Abhasa. Abhasa Ausha of Jiva and Para Ausha of the same Jiva, because Atma word is used. This is how you do Viveka, and then the entire Upanishad will fall in place. Otherwise, Upanishad will seem contradictory everywhere. Iti tasya shrutehe artha jneya. This has to be understood. Once you understand it, then this akanksha, this shanka won't be there. Chaitanya abhasa eva karma karta phaladata cha. Then who is the phaladata? We have seen earlier, Chaitanya abhasa is different at the different levels, because medium reflecting will change the reflection also in size. In the example, the reflection will vary in size and shape. In the exemplified, abhasa will vary based on the medium reflecting it. If the medium is avidya, then one becomes a karmakarta. If the medium is maya, then one becomes a phaladata. One meaning the one ekameva dvitiya chaitanya. That chaitanya, ekameva dvitiyam chaitanyam, will become karmakarta based on the reflection or abhasa caused by pratiphalita in avidya, manifesting in buddhi, antakarana, sharira, ityadi. And the same chaitanya pratiphalita in maya with maya sambandha becomes a karma phaladata associated with maya and maya kara with jagat. As Hiranyagarbha, as Virat, ityadi, natu shuddha chaitanyam. Shuddha chaitanya is neither the karmakarta nor the phaladata. Jiva swarupantargata chichhaya rupabhasaamshaha karmakaroti. So, abhasa, chidabhasa or chaitanyabhasa is chaya rupa. Reflection. Chaya can mean shadow also, but here light is there. Where light is there, you can't have the shadow. Shadow is due to the light, but it is not the... Where there is light, there can't be shadow. There itself. So, chaya can be understood as the reflection. Jiva swarupa antargata chichaya. That ausha, only that ausha, which is abhasa ausha, in the jiva, does the karma, karma karoti. Karma kuruvata abhasa aushasya, ishvara swarupa antargata chichaya rupa abhasa phalam, abhasa ausha phalam prayachati. So, phaladata is also abhasa at the samashti level. Ishvara swarupa antargata. Jiva swarupantargata chichaya is a karmakarta, and Ishvara swarupantargata chichaya rupa abhasa ausha, that chidabhasa at the samashti level, is the phaladata. Abhasa eva karmakarta, abhasa eva phaladata. Abhasa is a semblance, like a pratibimba. If you say, oh, pratibimba, did it, bimba didn't do anything, that is because of the doshas of the medium. Avidya causes it, causes the Chaitanya to have a semblance of being a karmakarta. And Maya, word which is a substitute for avidya, at the samashti level, causes the Chaitanya to have a semblance of phaladata. Just because there is abhasa does not make it real. That is why it is mithya. Abhasa is mithya. Anena ayam artha siddha. Thereby, what is the idea revealed in the Dvasuparna mantra? Jiva swarupantar gatabhasa aushav punyapapi kritva tat phalani bhunte. Ishvara nishtabhasa aushastu karma phalani prayachati iti. So, in the Dvasuparna mantra, jiva swarupa, the abhasamsha in the jiva-swarupa, jiva-swarupa has done punya-papa. And having done so, has to be a bhokta, therefore, tat-phalani-bhumte, swadvatti-phalam. But, ishvara-nishta-abhasamsha is not a bhokta. The abhasa at the samashti level is the karma-phaladata. Etad ubhayanugata chaitanyamshe na kapi vartasti. You cannot talk about chaitanya which is common between the two. Between both, the chaitanya is common, which is the bimba rupa. You cannot even have a talk there. You cannot even discuss from that level, because paramarthika drishti has no ausha at all. Chaitanya ausha is from the vyavaharika drishti. When you reach there, as in reaching being figurative there, cognitively, you look from the other side, which is the real side, then there is no division possible. And when there is no division, then there is no vyavahara, even talk is not possible there. Na kapi वार्ता अस्ति जीवगत चैतन्यांशे कर्म कर्तृत्व तत्फल भोक्तृत्व रूप संबंधो न वर्तते इन चैतन्य देयर इज नो संबंध विद कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व देयरफॉर कर्मकर्ता चैतन्य कैनॉट बी एंड चैतन्य कैनॉट बी कर्म फल दाता ऑल्सो ईश्वरगत चैतन्यांशे अपि न कर्म फल दातृत्व स्वरूप संबंधो अस्ति चैतन्य इन बोथ जीव एंड ईश्वर चैतन्य अंश इज फ्री फ्रॉम एनी संबंध बीइंग एन असंग चैतन्य देर कैनॉट बी कर्तृत्व भोक्तृत्व देर यस्तु तस्मिन् चैतन्ये कर्म कर्तृत्व फलदातृत्व आदिकं वर्णयति स मूर्ख एव सो वन हू सेज दैट दिस चैतन्य इज द कर्मकर्ता एंड चैतन्य इज द फलदाता I mean, as idamittham, satyataya varnayati. That should be added there. Otherwise, Shruti says that there is no one else. Varnayati means satyataya varnayati. When somebody is talking, this vartha is not possible. There one brings in this vartha and says, no, this is how this setup is. In moksha, this is how the setup will be. Just give me one moment. Sorry. So, yaha varnayati sa murkha eva, who discusses the bhedas as real and then the roles as real, karma karta and karma phaladata, is all chaitanya in reality. Then that person is a dullard. It's stupid to talk about divisions where divisions are not there. Yes, yatash chaitanyam ubhayatrapi asangam eka rupam cha vartate. Because in both places chaitanya is asanga, not associated at all. It is like creating division between Surya, who is reflected, whereas Surya is one, unaffected. Just because the Surya reflects, that is not the dosha of Surya. It is the dosha of the medium, which is flickery, which is multiple. There are multiple reflecting bodies, reflecting water bodies, and they are wavery. That is not the fault of Surya, who appears to be wavery, who appears to be many and wavery. Therefore, Chaitanya उभयत चैतन्यम यतश्च यतश्च चैतन्यम उभयत्रापि असंगम एकरूपं च वर्तते अतः यः चैतन्ये कर्मकर्तृत्व फलदातृत्व आदिकं वर्णयति स मूर्खैव सो दिस इज द हेतु फॉर द अर्लियर स्टेटमेंट यतः इज यस्मात् यस्मात् कारणात् चैतन्य मात्रेन कोऽपि भेदगंधो अस्ति सो भेद गंधोऽपि नास्ति कहा अपि वेद गंधः नास्ति चैतन्य मात्रे इन शुद्ध चैतन्य देयर इज नॉट इवन अ विफ लिटरली नॉट इवन अ विफ ऑफ भेद देयर इज नॉट इवन अ यू नो स्लाइट टिंज ऑफ डिविजन पॉसिबल यस्तु जीव चैतन्यम ईश्वर चैतन्यात् ईश्वर चैतन्यम वा जीव चैतन्यात् भिन्नतया मन्यते स विगर्ह एव भवति वन हू talks about differences, considers, manyate, one who considers difference between Jiva Chaitanya and Ishara Chaitanya, meaning, here it is said as Jiva Chaitanya is different from Ishara Chaitanya and Ishara Chaitanya, or Ishara Chaitanya from different from Jiva Chaitanya, that person should be censured, is censored. You should not take his teaching at all. You should not take his words as valid. He should be set aside. You know, he should be kept as Vedabhaya. Although not Vedabhaya, Vedarthabhaya. May not be Vedabhaya, but Vedarthabhaya. Who has not understood the purpose of the teaching. Who is lost in words. And so lost in words, who does not know that there will be a contradiction with other Shruti. They are reinterpreting. They are reinterpreting what need not be reinterpreted. or they are taking things at face value, not knowing that other things taken at face value will contradict here. You will not have samanvaya at all. You will not have ekavakyata. You will not have one purpose to the Shruti. Shruti will be talking about 1,000 things without any connection between each other. But there is an underlying current. Tatparya nishchaya has to be done. And this is something that we have learned in school days. What is the moral of the story? There are so many things happening in the story. But what is the moral of the story? There has to be a moral to the story. That is how the children are taught. Through Panchatantra stories, any dharmika katha, through itihasa incidents. Mahabharata, the entire Mahabharata is taught. But what is the essence of Mahabharata? That is in Gita. What is the essence of Gita? Shrutyartha. Bhagavan Krishna's, you know, like the milk, the comparison in the Dhyana Shloka is like the milk. Like the essence, milk is drawn out of the entire Shastras in the form of Gita. That is Shrutyartha. That Shrutyartha being Advaita, otherwise it is not possible. The setup itself is not possible. Vedas, if they are Satya, then Shruti is contradictory all over the place. Then how will you take it as a Pramana which is self-contradictory? You cannot have self-contradictory Pramana. The eyes see a green color in the leaf and then my ears do not see. That is not an issue. The ears cannot see at all. Let's say I see green color in a leaf and in the same leaf I see a red color as well. Then I see some other color. Then it is Bhranti. Assuming that the leaf does not change in the same moment. So, in the same moment, I look at the green color and then in some kind of lighting, it appears to be red. The lighting is creating a change in appearance of the leaf, but the leaf does not change. That is Vastu Tantra. My Jnana, Jnana is Vastu Tantra. Jnana is based on the way the Vastu is. I don't have a choice to see it red. A green leaf, seeing a green leaf as red is not my choice. I cannot make a choice. That won't change my jnana. If it does, then it is not jnana. It is not prama. Prama rupa jnana. It is brahma rupa jnana. That is also jnana, but it is not valid knowledge. Valid knowledge cannot be called as knowledge. Knowledge, the word used as knowledge is superficial there. So one who sees bheda, that is superficial meaning. And if it is contradictory, just like in the example of my eye seeing green color as well as red color at times, then my eye is not a pramana there. Then Shruti will also be a pramana if Shruti talks about differences as well as Advaita and both are real. If somewhere a Purana talks about Shiva being great, another Purana talks about Vishnu being great, both can be valid only when Shiva and Vishnu are forms of the same Ishvara. If you take as Shiva, no, Shiva is the Uttama Devata, like we saw in the Tippana when Ishvara was described, or Vishnu as the greatest of Devatas and he is Ishvara, then there will be contradiction between Puranas. Which one will you take as valid? Both can be valid only if Advaita is Itattva and the differences are superficial. Else, they will become Apramana. Shruti will also become Apramana. Tatha cha Shrutihi Brahmatam Paradat Yo Anyatra Atmano Brahma Veda. Atmana Anyatra Yaha Brahma Veda. One who Veda is Vetti there. It's an optional form of Vidhatu. Little Akara Pratyas are taken by Lat optionally for Vidhatu. So one who knows Brahma as different from Atmana. Atmana Anyatra Brahma. Veda Tam Paradat. So Brahmatam Paradat. You should keep him aside. Sarvam tam paradat yonyatra atmana sarvam veda. So, see, Brahmatam parad means one makes Brahma as far. You should keep, set that opinion aside. One who knows, he will make the Brahma as being far away, which is your own Swarupa. It becomes far as though, and sarva, everything becomes far as though, if one knows everything as separate from Atma. The Brihat Shruti says that, and Paradat is actually also meaning that you should set that person aside. Mrityasya mrityum apnoti ya iha naneva pashyati. Ya iha nana iva pashyati. Nana iva word is also given. Naneva pashyati is nana iva, as though there is plurality, dvaita or multiplicity, then that person will attain mrityu after mrityu, because he will continue in samsara. He will die this death and be born again and die again, be born again and die again. Therefore, he will attain death after death by attaining birth after birth. That is the idea there. Mrityo sa mrityu maapnoti. This is not the phala that we want. We want amrita phala. Moksha has to be amarana dharma. Amarana dharma ka moksha. Amrita. You cannot have mrityu in moksha. And if a person says that no, there is dvaita, then what is the phala? Mrityoho mrityum apnoti. That person will continue in samsara even if there is Vishnu Loka Vasa. There is Kailasa Vasa, Vaikuntha Vasa, Brahma Loka Vasa, even if there is no understanding of Advaita, then if Nana Iva Pashyati, even sees that as though there are Bhedas, then the person will take birth after birth and attain death after death. And Taittiriya Mantra also says the same thing. Udara Mantaram Kurute Atha Tasya Bhayam Bhavati. So one who makes even a little different, Ut Aram Antaram Kurute, one who does makes even a little difference, Antara, even a little difference, thereby what will happen? The resultant is bhaya. Dvitiyad vai bhayam bhavati elsewhere. There will be bhaya. There cannot be bhaya in moksha. If there is bhaya in moksha, who wants that kind of a moksha? Etena jiveshwarayor aikyabhyubagame karmopasana pratipadaka veda bhagaha anushtatra bhavat nirarthakasyat. Iti yam dvitiya shanka api idanim samahita. How so? How is the karma and upasana valid then? It is valid when you look at chidabhasa, not kutastha and brahma. Kutastha and brahma, there cannot be any difference. When the equation is made between jiva and ishvara, only the kutastha is equated with brahma. Upadhi is all different. Upadhi pratipalita, Chaitanyabhasas are different. Those are to be given up. And you land on Aikya. So there is no Bheda between the two there. The Bheda is at the Chidabhasa level. Thereby, Jiveshwarayo Aikya Abhyupagami. If you accept oneness between the two, still karma and upasana is possible as revealed by the Veda Bhaga. How so? By saying that Chidabhasa are different. Chidabhasa does the upasana and karma. Upasya is also Chidabhasa. Thereby, divisions are possible at the Upadhi level, and Upadhi level itself, karma and upasana are possible. At the Upadhi level, at the Mithya level itself, karma, phalakarta, bhokta, and karma phala also, the entire yavastha is possible. Dvaita vyavastha is possible. Nana iva is possible. And thereby, Shruti, which talks about Veda Bhaga, which reveals Pratipadaka Veda Bhaga of karma and upasana, will not be vyartha. So, Shankapi idanim samahita. जीवेश्वर अनुगत चैतन्य भागयोर अभेदः आभास भागयोर भेदश्चास्ति तस्माद् उभय विधयोरपि वेद भागयो प्रामाण्यम समंजसम. बट यू सेड दैट इफ देर आर कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन इन द श्रुति यू आर ऑल्सो डूइंग द सेम थिंग. द पूर्व पक्षी में से वेद भाग कर्मकांड भाग इवन सम पार्ट ऑफ ज्ञानकांड वेदांत उपनिषद टॉक्स अबाउट उपासना. The earlier bhaga talks about karma and upasana, and in Vedanta bhaga there is upasana and jnana, aikya jnana. Then dvaita and advaita, both are being talked about the shruti. Isn't shruti self-contradictory and therefore apramana? No. Why? Because jiveshwara anugata chaitanya bhaga or abhedaha. The abheda advaita tattva is revealed by Upanishad. Through not the all Upanishads in the sense entire Upanishad part on each and every Upanishad, but the tatpare is advaita in each and every Upanishad. But dvaita revealed as it is at the abhasa level, mithya level, abhasa bhaga. As long as one takes oneself as an individual, there will be duties. These duties are revealed by the shruti, and what has to be attained, there will be raga dvesha. How to take care of ragadveshas are also revealed by the same Shruti. Thereby, it is all valid. At the level of Upadhi, there is validity of Karmakanda and Upasanas. At the level of Moksha, as the Phala, the Advaita part of the Shruti, Advaita Pratipadaka Shruti is valid. Therefore, Ubhayo Vidayor Api Veda Bhagayo. The both parts of Vedas, which talk about Dvaita and Advaita, both are valid. Only an Advaitin can say this. No Advaitin can explain why there is even confusing Advaita there. If Dvaita is real, then Advaita need not be talked about at all. Has no prayojana at all. It cannot be just, you know, some kind of arthavada. As Purva Mimamsaka say, it is arthavada. It is glorification. It just gives the karta more focus by praising, you know. They butter you up and get things done. That's not the case. It is childish to interpret like that. Shruti takes so much of effort. Nobody takes so much of effort to butter up the person. Oh, you do this, you know, you are great. Just a few words, flowery words, will do. But the each and every Upanishad talks about Aikya. It cannot be just flowery words. So Tatparya Nishchaya has to be done. There you know what is the real focus of the Shruti. The others are also valid as the means. As long as you take yourself as a Karta, you have to be a Bhokta. You are a Karta only for Bhokta. Nobody chooses to become a karta and not be a bhokta. It may be an afterthought. Or while wanting to do something, really, you know, some kind of a papa karma. Oh, I want to do it. I want the result. But I want the immediate result. I don't want the long-term results. That one may think, but it is not possible. The result will be definite. Thereby, when one chooses to be a karta, then Shruti gives the means to attain the result. What is Veda? The Dvaita Bhaga of Veda is what? It is all alaukika upaya for laukika phala. Laukika or alaukika also, but it is an alaukika upaya. Somebody wants dhana, one may, you know, slog it out day in, day out in offices and businesses and earn money. One may otherwise do some kind of a sadhana at home, other upayas, alaukika, and try to get the same dhana. One may have health problems when one may run around doctors. Sometimes the doctors, you know, they can't help. Then one may take to dhanvantari mantra ityadi, alaukika upaya. We don't know how it works. We don't know how we work, let alone, you know, how the body works. How will we know how the medicines work? We don't know that either. But we take to it. Shraddha is there in the doctor, in the setup, scientific setup. Shraddha is there. Shraddha is there in Dhanvantari Mantra also. One does that and gets the same result. Laukika phala with alaukika upaya. All that is set up by the Shruti and Shastra when one is in Dvaita, when one is wanting some Vishaya, something from the Vishaya. If one wants Moksha, then just the mode switch takes place in the Sadhaka. The person has become a Sadhaka now, Mumukshu instead of the Phalaichu. Karma Phalaichu was the earlier case. And then this person suddenly or gradually, need not be suddenly, changes to become from becoming a Phalaichu to Mumukshu. And thereby, both are valid. Tasmad Ubhaya Vidayurapi Veda Bhagayo Pramanyam Samanjasam. We'll continue in the next part. Sukha Nityam Suprakasham Vyapakan Namarupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Podhyam Buddhya Rukyatva Nirvana Param Sarva Vedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramah Tadeva Amnotto Iti Me Nishchita Matihi Tatsat. Namaste.
Namaste.